Healthstaff. Adam, how are you?
I'm doing well. How about yourself?
Not too bad. Quick little intro on yourself and a little bit about Lead Healthstaff, if you don't mind.
Yeah, so I am the Director of Digital Operations here at Lead Healthstaff. Basically, I am the intersection of all things technology that flow into Lead to make sure that all of our operations are efficient and effective, and all of our technology plays nicely together in the sandbox. Just do my best to really try and allow our C-level executives to make good decisions is what I try and set them up for. Lead Healthstaff, we do travel nursing. We had primarily done a lot of California travel nursing. Now we are national, but we do exclusively travel nursing.
Beautiful. And your guys' team seems to be growing. How many recruiters you guys have now?
So we are up to 12 recruiters. 12 recruiters and 4 account managers, which is up pretty significantly. We went from about 80, I would say about 80 or so nurses on assignment, and we're about 225 now.
Nice.
Nurses on assignment.
That's a nice jump.
Yep. COVID helped, unfortunately, and fortunately, right?
Yes, the pros and the cons, eh?
Yep.
But all good stuff. So, I mean, you know, Lead Healthstaff has been great recruiters for a handful of months now. And I was just curious, like, what kind of drew, you know, your team, yourself, Lead Health, you know, two great recruiters? What need did you see our product kind of filling for you guys?
Yeah, it's a great question. I mean, we do our best to lead with our why, right? Which is trying to provide value to the nurses, right? So for us, that pretty much governs every decision we make, is how much value is this providing to the nurse? And so there's no better way to find out is to get feedback directly from these nurse clinicians, right? And hear exactly where we're failing or where we're succeeding. And we had been doing some internal surveys. Unfortunately, really felt like the internal surveys didn't really have as much credibility as great recruiters lend itself to. Having a third party actually conduct the surveys for us gave us a certain level of credibility. For the nurses, honestly, our participation rate went up once we started going through great recruiters in our surveys. And then also the ease and transparency of being able to take that feedback and data, both process it internally, make whatever changes needed to be made, or process that externally and put it on our website, put it on social media, let the world see. I mean, we're pretty big on trying to be as transparent as possible. So honestly, great recruiters allowing us to get access to that data and be transparent were the big things.
Oh, beautiful. Yeah, I mean, some good points there. We hear that from quite a few of our customers. Always kind of curious, you mentioned, you know, pinpointing areas where you guys had the opportunity to improve or could have been falling short, or there was a gap in a process. Did you guys found anything throughout this feedback that you're receiving that, you know, spurred any changes or implementations that were different from how you guys were previously operating?
Yeah, we have. Honestly, there was a recruiting process had been streamlined pretty well in the last year or so. Unfortunately, we were still lagging behind in some of the other areas of our kind of back office of our business, right? So I think the reviews exposed the fact that our process was a bit flawed and taking too much time. So we pivoted and made some changes, adopted some new technology, which we're currently implementing now, that should change all of that and kind of really put us ahead of, I think, most of our competition as far as streamlining the compliance process and that back office process. So yes, absolutely.
Beautiful.
There was some validation, but also some tough criticism that I think it's very important for us to get.
No, for sure. Absolutely. I agree. And again, you know, I've had other clients mention those kind of similar things where they didn't know that, oh, you know, XYZ in our onboarding process was too long or taking too much time or cumbersome, and make changes that now are improving the experience and, you know, increasing their retention rates.
And you'd be surprised, sometimes it's things as simple as communication, right? Sometimes the processes are good, but we just, you know, aren't doing as good a job as we should of communicating what the process is, outlining the timelines, right? The expectations, setting those for the clinicians properly. And some of it was as simple as that. Some of it was more complex, again, adopting some new technology, but, you know, it's all super helpful to just find out where we're missing the mark.
Absolutely. And, you know, from a team perspective, you know, obviously the team has grown a bit, and you're getting more, you know, more placements on the travel side. You know, how has Great Recruiters been, you know, received by the team? That could be, you know, from C level down to the recruiters. Is there a buy-in? You know, what are the recruiters, from your perspective, do they like getting that kind of feedback? What does it do for them?
Yes. Fortunately, we've gotten a lot of positive feedback about the recruiters themselves, so I think that makes things a bit more palatable. But we've certainly, even at the times that we've gotten some harsh or constructive criticism, I should say, it's been presented in such a way that was easily digestible and I think handled very well from the Great Recruiters platform and then also by our leadership team that has you know, disseminated that information, made the appropriate changes, addressed it in such a way that people could really use that as constructive criticism and get better. But there is a huge buy-in from everybody. Obviously, everybody's really excited about having things on our website, right? But there's a huge buy-in from the recruiters as well to try and get to the, you know, the certain number of reviews that you need in order to, you know,
certification.
Get everything. Yeah, get your certification, get everything put into your signature, and really give yourself the the boost that you need. So we found there's a lot of internal competition between them to get the most reviews coming back and to try and get those out to people. So huge buy-in and honestly, like I said, just really effective as far as getting it out into even their personal social media presence that's out there to say, this is me, this is how you can find out more about me. This is another layer of transparency that we have, not only for lead health staff, but really for the individual recruiters.
We see it's a big boost. I just pulled up, you know, your dashboard, and again, your guys' scores are, you know, above average in all the categories. Those five key traits: genuine, responsive, experienced, advisor, transparent. Your NPS score, well up there. Response right up there. Again, you got a couple recruiters who have that individual certification, Amber and Jason, so they can kind of stand out, use those profiles and whatnot. So a lot of good things happening for the team for sure.
Yeah, I mean, especially there are a couple of our senior recruiters, and we've got a few more senior recruiters that are starting to spike up in their number of reviews. Yeah. But, you know, even for the you know, more inexperienced recruiters that we have on our team, it's been incredible to just see some of the things that have come back from Great Recruiters. And honestly, not just the constructive criticism, but even the positive feedback to let them know that, hey, what they're doing is working. Yeah. And I think when you're just starting out as a recruiter, it's a little scary. The candidates or the clinicians tend to know more than you do about the jobs you're recruiting them for, and it's a bit intimidating. And so it's nice to get that validation from something like Great Recruiters that comes back and says, hey, you know, here's a five-star review, and here's, you know, what you're doing great. You always got back to me in a timely manner. It kind of puts things into perspective, right? What are the things that really matter to those candidates or those clinicians? And it's things as simple as communication, right? Getting back to me when you're doing what you say that you're going to do, setting clear expectations, all of those things that, you know, anybody should be able to do and get the validation for doing well.
Yeah, and that was the word I was going to use, if you didn't bring it up, was validation. That we see a lot of, especially for new recruiters, whether they're new to the industry in general or new to travel nursing, find this platform very impactful, because they, you know, if they're falling short here, they catch it early, but they get that validation, like, oh, like, okay, maybe I am pretty good at this. And I, you know, like that kind of confidence boost, not only for the individual, but for the whole team.
Yeah, and it's you know, you mentioned the scores as well, right? I think it's important that you're not only breaking down the NPS, right? And giving an overall, you know, 5-star, 4-star, whatever the stars may be that the person is giving you, but also to break it down into those categories, because then we can really isolate where somebody, you know, might be falling short, or, you know, somebody that's doing really well still may not get as high a score in one of those categories, and that's an area they can improve upon, right? We definitely don't think we're perfect, and we know we've got lots of improvement to make. So I think the more constructive criticism we can get, the better off we are to make sure we're making the improvements that are being requested, not the ones we think we should be making.
Yeah, no, 100%. And, you know, we just kind of talked about the results and the scores being high, like from a internal results standpoint, like looking at it from your technology standpoint, from what you and leadership wanted to get out of the platform. Where do you guys feel you're at so far?
Yeah, it's a tremendous response as far as the reviews are coming back. And we've actually gotten a nice spike in references as well, which has made the referral process pretty easy too, flowing through great recruiters. So, you know, even some of our newer recruiters that we've brought into the Great Recruiters platform this past week have already gotten a couple of reviews to come back from some people. So just makes that process really easy as well. So, you know, from an ROI standpoint, it's hard to put a number on some of these things because of the intangibles. You know, great recruiters helped us do this or do that and adopt this. And I can tell you wholeheartedly that, you know, we're better off since adopting great recruiters because of the constructive criticism we received, because of the accolades we've received that's helped us from a marketing perspective, right? And I know some of those things can be harder to calculate. The referrals are probably the easiest one to calculate and say, well, this is where we've gotten and this is some of the financial return we've gotten. But honestly, I think I would be selling the product far short if I said that that was the only ROI that we're getting, because I think those intangibles are so big. I mean, the marketing alone and validation of that marketing on our website, on our social media, it's even just fun internally. I mean, we get these reviews back and as leadership, we share them, you know, in our Google chat with the whole company and say, hey, look at the great review that Emily got or that Jason got or, you know, Amber got today. And we just give them the accolades they deserve, because I feel like every one of those wins deserves to be praised. The fact that somebody took the time to actually respond and say, you know, thank you, you're doing a good job at this, it deserves to be called out. And you guys have done a great job of helping us do that very simply.
Well, I mean, love to hear that, because again, you know, some companies only look at this like, oh, well, let's get that hard ROI, but there's so much more that, you know, we think we bring, and that, you know, hearing that from you is, I mean, again, validation that we're helping companies like yourselves that are looking to not only get better, but show the great work they're doing, support their team, support their staff, the recruiters, all that good stuff. So, yeah, I mean, love to hear that, and some real good stuff happening over that lead for sure.
Do what we can for sure, but definitely, you know, it's partners that make it possible, right? I mean, we're trying to do something different than everybody else is doing. And again, we're trying to make decisions that we think are best, but we really need to hear from people that we're serving to make sure that we're providing them with the value, because ultimately that does govern our decisions. And every single piece of technology we buy is to make the nurse's life easier in some way, shape, or form. And then we're a byproduct of that, right? How can we conform to that? So, you know, without honest reviews and feedback, it'd be really tough for us to make those kinds of decisions. And we can send out all the kind of emails and questions we want, but, you know, we found that that third party kind of result that we're getting from great recruiters has been, again, go back to that word validity, right? But it provides a certain amount of validation to it. And again, the response rates have been higher because they don't feel like they're being solicited by us directly and it's falling on deaf ears. It almost gives them the knowledge that it's going to be addressed if they give positive or negative criticism.
I'll say there was, I mean, a little side note, there was just an article that came out from Inc. magazine that like this, the Great Resignation or whatever they're calling, mm-hmm. like, quitting, that majority of people, while yes, pay and stuff is a factor, and a majority of people just don't feel heard, and that there's no channel for them to get their thoughts across, and if they do, there's no action taken on.
Yes.
So, I mean, having something like this in place where you guys are looking to improve upon that and following up with those candidates, I think goes a long way in growing a company and becoming a better company, but also keeping your clients, your staff, both internal and external, happier with those, you know, from that standpoint, and keeping those retention rates high and those relationships.
Yeah, it's funny that you hope, but I think we are proof that, you know, if you do the right things for the right reasons, the rest of the things will fall into place. You know, and we keep going back to this, trying to do what's best for the nurses. We honestly believe at our core that if we are doing everything we can to provide a better life for them and to help them as much as possible, we'll be a successful business. That will just be a natural byproduct of doing the right thing.
Yeah, you know, I know you guys might be looking to do a little more with us as far as capturing more feedback in different places. I mean, that's coming down the pipeline, hopefully. But anything else that you know, when you think of great recruiters and lead health and that relationship and what it's adding to the team, anything else that you'd like to toss out there?
No, I think there's definitely some opportunity for us to expand the relationship, right? I know We talked about some other ways, honestly, any way that we can apply Great Recruiter's kind of functionality, methodology and technology into other areas of our business would be extremely impactful, because it would, I'm sure, have the same results that we've seen on the recruiting side and on the nursing side, right? So if we can kind of get that going in some other areas of the process, I think we'd see some tremendous results with our business there as well. So I'm looking forward to it, looking forward to how we can expand and honestly just get creative. That's the best part of partnerships, right? Is what's working for us, what's not working. And I think a great partner is really somebody that doesn't have a cookie cutter product, but is willing to expand and evolve and move their roadmap based on the feedback they're getting from their partners, just like we do. So you guys are doing a great job of certainly listening to us, making some changes when they're needed to be. You know, hopefully we're giving you the accolades you deserve, but also, you know, helping us grow, right? What can we be doing differently? How can we help both of our companies grow? You know, we are of the mindset that, you know, the better you do, the better we do. So if we can give you some ideas and have you guys pivot and put some things on your roadmap that benefits you, it's going to benefit us.